Most AI avatar videos fall apart for one reason. They loop. Same hand gesture, same head tilt, same 5-second animation on repeat. And the moment your audience notices it, they click off. But the craziest part is your avatar doesn't have to repeat anything. You can make full 20-40-second clips with natural gestures, shifting expressions, and new hand movements, and smooth transitions, all from one character with zero looping. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to break past the auto loop barrier and generate longer, cleaner, natural animations that actually look human. If you want your avatar to feel like a real person instead of a GIF, keep watching because this is the trick nobody teaches. What you will need is 2 frames, your first frame and your last frame. You need both of these, and in between these, when you generate your video, you will put gestures. To create your beginning and end frame, you're going to do it on Google Gemini Nano Banana. So you're just going to put in your image of your avatar, and then you're going to describe the last frame so that you can go from one frame to the next. Don't worry, I am going to show you. So I put show her standing with her hands on her hips. Then it gives me this image here. So it's still her, it just changes her pose and what she was doing. So that's usually what you want to do. So then you're going to take both images and you're going to save them and then take them over to OpenArt. Now this is where I create my videos. There's also many other tools you can use on here too. I'm just on Safari. So you click video and you can either upload text, image, elements, or video, but we're using video. You can also choose a model like a video generator. They also have Sora, Wand 2.5, Pixverse, Halu, but today we're using Kling 2.5 because it gives you a start frame and an end frame. So for your start frame, you're going to upload what you want her to start out with. We're going to use this image. And then for your end frame, you're going to use the other image, the one where she's standing, this image here. Once you're done, you have to put in a prompt. I'm going to come over to my community, click classroom, and I'm going to scroll all the way down until I see creator cache. Then I'm going to choose the hand gestures, and I'm going to choose one out of these. Now, I have so many hand gestures on here. Now, each hand gesture has 3 gestures in 1 so that your character or your avatar will look very natural when they're talking. 3 hand gestures are just enough to create a video.
If you want more gesture ideas like these, inside my community, I put together a full list of hand movement prompts you can copy and use. Everything from natural one-hand gestures to big expressive motions to subtle micro movements for talking scenes. These are the exact prompts I use when I'm creating longer, realistic avatar videos. So if gestures are something you're struggling with, the list inside the community makes it way easier.
Then you're going to paste it in the optional prompt box, and then you're going to go down and click on 10-second duration. 10 seconds will make sure all 3 of the gestures get put into the prompt. Then you go down, and you can put negative prompts if you like. I usually don't have to. And then you click create. Once it's done, it's going to look like this. So she's done all of them. She's standing up from her chair. And then she ends with the end frame of her with her hands on her hips. Doing it this way, you can make way longer videos. Now I'm going to show you using this method to create 30 to 60 second long clips. This time you'll have a starting frame and an end frame, and both of these will be the same. The gestures will go in the middle when you generate it, so she'll look like she's talking naturally. You're going to go back to OpenArt, and you're going to make sure you're on Kling 2.5, and the start frame and the end frame have to be the same. Then you're going to grab another prompt, and you're going to paste it in the optional prompt box. I'm just going to paste one in, and then you're going to go down. You're going to do the exact same thing that you've done before, and you're going to click 10 seconds, and then you're going to click Create. Once you click Create, this is the prompt that you get. So it's a 10-second long video. It has all 3 gestures in it, so it makes her look and talk more naturally. Now you can do this as many times as you want. Each clip will be 10 seconds, and you can use different prompts like this. I'm going to show you over on CapCut. This is how I created a 30-second clip. And you don't have to loop. You don't have to
duplicate and reverse the second clip. No, it just put them all in and then it just goes right into the next one. Because when you use the starting frame and the end frame, you can continue to use the same image. So if you want her to do anything else, then you just make her do something else like I showed you the first time. Once you have the clip all done and you have your video as long as you want it, I'm just doing about 30 seconds, you can click export. Now, if you want your avatar to sing or talk, you just bring the clip that you have over to sync.so. You can generate up to 60 seconds of a video. So you just click create project, name it. I just put anything, upload your video of your avatar, and then you upload your audio and click lip sync. And then when you're done, this is what you'll get. I love how specific the lip sync is.
If this helped you, check the description. I left everything linked so you can keep learning.
She has the facial features and the facial expressions, hand movements. She looks amazing. This is just the 10-second clip, but this is a 30-second clip. You can do up to 60 seconds on a free account.
If you want more gesture ideas like these, inside my community, I put together a full list of hand movement prompts you can copy and use. Everything from natural one-hand gestures to big expressive motions to subtle micro movements for talking scenes. These are the exact prompts.
Once your video is done lip syncing, you're just going to go to the top and click the three little dots and then click download and it will download straight to your phone. Remember, if you want it to look natural, you always need to start with a start frame and an end frame, and they have to be the same.
Inside my community, I break everything down step by step. How to get consistent avatars, longer animations, better hands, cleaner skin, natural motion, and the real workflow I use every day. You also get updated prompts, new tools, weekly breakdowns, and support from people learning the same thing. So if you're trying to level up your AI videos, that's where I go deeper so you don't have to figure everything out alone. If this helped you, check the description. I left everything linked so you can keep learning the advanced stuff at your own pace. Thanks for watching.